Hi everyone, it's DJ here from Cozy RC. Today we got the wild thing in the workshop and I'm going to discuss the cost of building this boat. I will give you a full detailed breakdown of all the costs, so let's start. Starting with the hull material. The hull is made from wood. I used 1.5 mm for the bottom and 1.0 mm for the sides and the top. I buy the sheets 1 meter long by 50 centimeters wide. Well, this one is already cut as you see. And the 1 mm sheet is €21.90. And the 1.5 mm sheet is €20.90. For the bulkheads, such as these over here, here, and also in the bow section, I use lower grade wood, which costs €7.50 for one sheet of 1 meter by 0.5 meter. For the transom, the motor bracket and this longitudinal ribs, I use high grade birch plywood, 3 mm thickness. We got the sheet over here. This sheet is 25 centimeters by 50 centimeters and the cost is about €10. The frames and bulkheads of the boat I glue with CA glue. This is a package of 7.5 grams. It's enough to glue the whole boat, for the framing at least. And this package costs about €7. I reinforce my entire boat with glass weave. I got it over here. This is the 80 grams per square meter glass weave. And this is laminated onto the hull with epoxy, which you can see over here. And the weave is about €15 to cover the whole boat. And this epoxy is about €30, but you only need half of the package, so I will count it for €15. To keep your boat afloat, when you crash, I put pool noodle in the boat, and one pool noodle is 1 meter long, and it is enough for one boat like this, and it costs about €2.50. I use aluminium tube for the water cooling. I just buy it as a straight rod and I bend it. And one rod of 1 meter length is about €4. For mounting the hardware at the transom, such as the water pickup and the turn fins, I use aluminium corner profile. This is 30 millimeter by 30 millimeter by 1.5 millimeter. And 1 meter length is about €8. The turn fins, water pickup bracket, and the rudder, which is now not present because I'm making a new one. These are made from carbon fiber plates, 2 mm, which I got over here. And such a plate of 20 centimeters by 40 centimeters costs about €25, but you only need a small part of it. So I will count it for €8. The silicon tube for the water cooling, also used here, is a 4 mm internal diameter, 6 mm outer diameter, and 1 meter of this silicon hose is €3. The steering servo I use is a digital steering servo with metal gears. It's very popular. You can find it on eBay, on big Chinese websites, and the cost is about €16 for one piece. It already comes with the servo arm, so it's a good deal. The steering push rod and the rubber bellow both are about €2.50, so total €5. The thumb screws, M3 size, and all the fasteners which I used to mount the hardware on the transom are €6.50 together. The stock connectors that come with the motor and the ESC I replaced for 5 mm bullet connectors, and these come in bulk, but if you count for 3 pair, they cost about 50 cents. All the primer and paint that went on this boat altogether is about €45, but you can definitely save cost if you just keep it natural wood and apply clear coat or just a unicolor. The decals applied to this boat I printed myself on laser printed paper. And one slide of this paper is about 3 euros, and I use two slides, so that is 6 euros. This Stinger drive is from TFL. It runs a 4.76 millimeter shaft, which is included, and the cost is about 30 euros. The prop is about 20 euros for a beryllium prop. Currently I installed a CNC cut aluminium prop, which is a little more expensive, about 25 euros. The trim tabs are also from TFL, and they cost 14 euros 30 cents for a pair. The motor is a 40 millimeter by 74 millimeter long rocket motor, 2000 kV. I bought it at a Black Friday deal for 56 euros. That is including the water jacket. The motor coupler is from TFL and it is about 7.5 euros. The flex shaft is about 8 euros for a 300 millimeter length with a square end. The speed controller is a Flycolor 150 amps and I bought it also at a Black Friday deal for 50.6 euros. I am running a 6S setup, so the battery is relatively expensive. However, this CNHL battery I got for a great deal. It was a 2-for-1, so for one I paid 57 euros. I'm using XT90S anti-spark connectors on the LiPo and on the ESC, and for a pair you pay about 4 euros 20 cents. The straps to keep the LiPo in place were about 2 euros and 20 cents. The brass tube and the Teflon liner for the flex shaft together are about 10 euros. Finally, the transmitter and receiver. I'm using a GT2E transmitter. This is a very cheap transmitter. It is resold by different suppliers. I really like it. It only requires 4 AA batteries, and these batteries last forever. And it has all the basic functionalities that you require. So subtrim, reverse, endpoint. So yeah, I have some more higher end radios, but I just really like this one. And the price for the transmitter and the receiver together is about 30 euros. All right, so wrapping up all the costs, I will put the overview in the screen of all the costs. Actually, the stuffing tube and the Teflon liner for the flex shaft I forgot, so you have to add that to the total cost, and then the total cost will be 500 euros. Keep in mind that this is the cost for a high performance racing boat like this. This boat reaches more than 110 km/h. If you don't want that high speed, if you want for example around 50 miles an hour, you can definitely buy or make your boat cheaper. For example, using a 36 millimeter motor, 120 amp ESC and a 4S setup, that will already reduce the cost quite a lot. I hope you liked the video. If you would like more videos like this, like a cost breakdown of my different boats, such as my F1 tunnel or any of my other boats, please let me know, and I hope to see you guys later. Bye!